Donald Trump fared better with religious voters than the last three Republican candidates, and in no place was that more evident than in Ohio.
Talk about life as Trump voters.
Hey, if I want something better for our country, call me what you want to.
Just because we have a different viewpoint, because we made a different choice politically, doesn't mean we're bad people.
Lake County, Ohio, may be just 30 minutes from Cleveland, but it's a world away from the big city. Home to nearly 200 churches and houses of worship, faith matters here. It's where Mormon families like the Christiansons,
they're very sacred,
teach their children about love and respect. A place that voted for Barack Obama 8 years ago, but this time for Donald Trump.
I wasn't inviting this person into my home to raise my kids. I was inviting them to, you know, be our head of state, our leader.
I first met Bobby Christensen before the election. We came to Lake County to talk to women who were struggling with their choices.
Tell me how you get over the character concerns with Trump.
I don't think you get over it.
I came to see you right after the Access Hollywood tape had come out. Talk about how you processed, how you accepted his character.
I talked to my kids about how the behavior was unacceptable, how men should be treating women with respect. I hate to say I just came to terms with it, but I did. It's like I said, I'm not inviting him to teach my kids morals. That's my job.
Yeah. Here comes food.
We've met up with Bobby and some of her neighbors at a popular restaurant in town. Donna and Rick Downing and John Cadell all voted for Donald Trump.
Did faith play any role in how you went about making a choice for president this year?
Only from the perspective that I viewed Donald Trump as a candidate who would protect religious freedom.
You're all nodding your head.
I think that was a huge thing for a lot of people. I think people were terrified.
On Sundays, this place is hopping with the after-church crowd. The owner is a Syrian immigrant.
This community, they welcome me. And they are my family. I don't have no family over here.
Tony Atiyah moved here 30 years ago.
Our community is a good community. People that care about each other. And they don't look at people as far as color or religion or race. If you're a good person, you're welcome to our community.
That also means welcoming all debate at these tables.
Our borders need to be, they don't need to be locked down completely tight, but they need to be secured.
So his promise for extreme vetting, you were behind that and behind the wall. Do you think we should let anyone in from war-torn Syria?
You know, my heart goes out to Syrian refugees, and maybe that's my faith speaking. I mean, it tears me up to see the images that I see on TV and the stories of the little children. I think we all have a heart. We want to reach out to people. We want to give to people. We do a lot of good for the world. But to continue doing that, we have to protect ourselves.
If he sat here today and you were to give him some advice for his first 100 days, what advice would you give President Trump?
Be respectful of all you meet.
Stick to your word, follow through on what you said you were going to do.
I would reiterate that he needs to stay humble and to listen to the advisors that he's putting around him and, you know, fully consider what they're saying to him.
Every thought and emotion that comes to the top of his head spills out his mouth. I don't think it's a bad thing.
I hate to say my expectations for his presidency are low, but I think I'm keeping them low so that if he hits a bar, I can raise my standards a little bit. Neither candidate was great. I got the one in that I thought was better. Now let's see what he does.
If there's one thing I could say that I would like to see Donald Trump change, and that's the use of the name calling. I don't think it really has any place. Our country is so divided. We definitely need somebody to lead the way to turn things around.
Do Trump voters have a role in making us less divided?
I would just hope that every individual that voted for Trump, you know, extends a love or a warm inclusiveness. I think that if every Trump voter could do that, I mean, think about how many there are. I think our country would be much less divided if we stopped saying, who'd you vote for? And just were friendly and extended that hand.
Interesting that advice for the first 100 days. Stay humble, but follow through on what you said you were going to do.
And every one of them wants him to filter his words a little more carefully. This is not Democrats or the media. These are his hardcore supporters.
And we see this in the numbers we talked about earlier with Twitter, and it's that same advice that you're hearing from people in Ohio.
Yeah, and I've worked for presidents. It's hard to get through to them as an annoying staffer or you show them a poll, but their base, that's who they usually listen to.
Very interesting, Nicole. Thank you.
Thanks,
very much.
Thank you, guys.
Hello,
show today, fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.